bad to you right now. Yeah. But first I get my guitar in tune. Okay. I feel a good soul this thing right here on the screen. I'm gonna introduce this guy right here, right now. We're so honored to have him, man. He came to us at a time when we needed to fill an impossible slot. Our brother David had needed to take some time off to get his medical thing together, and now he's feeling great. And he really appreciates all the love and prayers that we've all given him. And in that period of time, one of our key team members, Jordan, said, "I got a guy." And he got a guy right here. And I go, wait, it gets better. He came in, he learned this whole show in 2 days. Nailed it. Cat knew it better than we did. And it's just grown over the last year and a half. He's really become a part of the family. We adore this guy. I love this guy so much. I love him so much, I tried to adopt him, but his parents said no. You've heard him with his band Ghost Note, and you definitely saw him on the last Prince tour. 27-year-old badass right there, Xavier X! Oh, this guy right here. We've been through the trenches. All right, to put a spotlight on him. We met the first day of, in June, 77, going on the first day of rehearsal of Boss Gags. He'd come from the East Coast and obviously West Coast here. And we had a great rehearsal, and that night he needed a lift home. I gave him a ride home. We've been brothers ever since. He's played on everything we've ever done, in and outside of the band. Thousands of records from the Rolling Stones to our brother Joe Bonamassa. He's got a killer solo album out. Make sure you get it. There he is, the legend that is, Lenny Kestra! Back here, a man I never leave home without. We play in Ringo Starr's band together, and you've heard him, as a matter of fact, we were here 2 months ago. But, and you've heard him with Kansas, and his original band, Blood Rock, with their number one single, DOA, which he refuses to sing, unless he grows his hair really long and all that sort of thing. A brilliant talent, great vocalist, multi-instrumentalist, and rumor has it that Cher shaved him from head to toe one night on the band. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Fabulous himself, Warren Crazy high vocals, as I mentioned before, he's the one that keeps us honest in all this stuff. He's got perfect pitch and nails this stuff every night. I don't even know how he does it. Great bass player, incredible singer. You probably saw him with Kenny Loggins. He was his musical director, Don Felder. He's got a lot of stuff going on. Make sure you keep your eyes out for this cat right here while he goes on his journeys. Please give it up for Sam Von Schreck. I told him, once he starts hitting the gym, he's going to get a better gig. Wow. On the drum set, he is so badass that we have to put a cage around him because you never know what kind of bodily fluids will go flying anywhere. Seriously though, man, you've probably seen him with, Boss Gags, Donald Fagen. He produced Michael McDonald's brand new record. Literally thousands of hit records out of Nashville. He's the A guy there. Producer, engineer, dear friend, and the bartender for the Moscow Mules. Oh Lord, we'll miss him. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Shannon Forrest! Wait, the Dolphins just said Mike McDonald needs help. Yeah, Did anybody see that Family Guy stuff we were in? That was the greatest moment of my life. Are you kidding? I'm a bit of a fan. It's wild. Anyway, over here, a cat that I've known since we were 14 years old. Absolutely one of my favorite cats of all time, not to mention his talents. But when we were young, I was in a band with his brother Mark, and his beautiful sister Jenny was hanging out, and his father, the maestro, used to set up a speaker somehow. I don't even know how he did it. So he was just to check out people's reactions to the new movie themes he was working on at the time. It was very ahead of its time in the 70s. A brilliant man, comes up with brilliant ideas. So I just happened by one day to see what the guys were up to, and I knocked on the door, or pressed the doorbell, and went, movie wasn't on, and I was like, what the That never happened. It's a great joke, I just made it up. Seemed like it'd be interesting. Okay, you guys didn't like it, but I did. How great is he singing for you tonight? Come on! Tell him the hottest working man in show business today, Mr. Please, 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 give it up for Joseph Williams! As they say in The Wizard of Oz, I saved him for last. What can I say, man? It all started in his parents' garage, which was a nice studio, actually. The bathroom's back there, brother. I told you to stay away from those hot tamales. Nobody knew. Anyway. Now, let me get back to this. My brother right here, it all started out in his parents' garage. And there was so much beautiful music and love in that house. It was really a wonderful time for us. I got so much to say, I can't say much right now. There's an orchestra at his fingertips right there that very few understand except for him and Jordan and David Page, but you know, he's, I don't know, that's a whole other thing. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the most beautiful cats ever, man, I owe him a lot. I wouldn't be standing here if it wasn't for him and his brothers and his family. Please grab his solo album, it's absolutely brilliant. Let's really hear you scream for the man right there, that guy right there. The one and only legend, Steve Lukather!
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? It is my duty to inform you that aliens are real!
Actually, usually right now I do some stupid alien thing to introduce Luke, but I'm not going to do that tonight because this is the last show. And I think it's important to point out that this guy right here has been in this band from the very beginning to right now. He's been this man standing the whole time. He's my personal escort. Is the greatest guitarist on this planet or any other, Mr. Steve Lukather!
This is hard, man. Huh?